So the sun is rising on another day in Imperium. I assume that it's gonna rise over here, if I'm not mistaken, because it's set over here. But the moon... Oh, is there a couple of moons? Or maybe there's like a moon cycle? That's pretty cool. All right, guys, we are back in Imperium. I hope you guys have been enjoying this series so far. It's actually a really fun game that I am enjoying quite a lot. I just made some more fuel packs with the pellets that we had from Promethean, and I think we're going to head over there today and get some more. But what we need to focus on as well... let's go to 6. So we just ate a food ration. Cool. But yeah, something we will probably focus on today is trying to set up some food. So if we look inside here in the crafter, I'm actually getting ready to make... what was it I was going to make? I think I want to make one of these food processors. So I'm going to need 2 computers. Which the computers... not that tough, but it takes a control device. So I'm going to need 2. I'm going to need 4 metal components. I'm going to need 4 cables. And I'm going to need 4 electronics. Just like so. I also made a capacitor device. I was going to make... there's something else I was going to make here. I done forgot what it was. Fuel tank. No, I got that. I got that. I got that. Thrusters. I have that. What in the heck was I gonna make? It took a capacitor device, whatever it was. Oh, maybe it was a small generator. That's what it was. I was gonna make one of these, but it actually turns out to be kind of tough to make. Just because of the amount of supplies that it's going to take. So I need to make another capacitor device. So let's look at that. So we're going to need 2 metal components. 1, 2, 3 cables. And 1 electronic. And that should make me another one of those. And then with the generator, I'm going to need a 12 metal components. So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Not bad. 1 reactor core, which is a motor, and some pipes. I'll make a motor. Let's turn that off for a second. Turn that back on, because that was not what we wanted to make. We want to make that. Okay. So yeah, there's the sun behind us. Perfect. You can see it rising. Let's go ahead and head up here to this Promethean ore deposit and see about getting this deposit. And then if we can do that, we might take a trip down to that over there, whatever that might be. But I want to pull out my gun here because I'm a little nervous. You know, I haven't traveled too far, like, basically what you've seen me is that... I heard something. Oh, it's just those guys. It looks like there's something built over that way. But we don't want to spend too much time away, because we are only about half oxygen. So we want to keep that in mind, if we can. We just picked up some eggplants. I wonder if they call it eggplant because it literally looks like an egg, or if it resembles eggplant in Earth. Or on Earth, not in Earth, on Earth. So I did figure out why my save was not there. Remember I changed my name at the beginning of the episode to be Drax. Well, apparently it saves per name. And so I changed it to Drax LP and it was all of a sudden there, but my old save was not. So I changed it back to player and it was there. So if you notice that, check that. That was a pretty big little thing. What is that? That's a weird looking plant. Okay, that's a pretty big little base over That's a pretty big base over there. A neodymium deposit. So we're getting close to this. You see that? Is it coming for me? I hear footsteps. Oh, is that thing coming for me? Why can't I? Oh my goodness. We get some raw meat and some alien parts. That thing sucked. Alright. You've been bitten and you're now poisoned. Use antidote or large med kit. Alright, let's do some digging here real quick. That is super loud. Let's go ahead and hit the audio, total music, and total volume and music. Take this out. I'm assuming because it's blue, we hit the Promethean. And there should be... Oh, there's some. Yeah, there it is. Cool. Just keep on taking it out. There's some more. And there's some more yet. Oh, yeah. We're getting a bunch. My phone's going off. Give me a moment. All right. So I came back down off the hill, got some health back, and I'm coming over here to our area over here, and I see these things. I've never seen these things before, and I'm not entirely sure what they are. They don't seem to be, like, focusing me. So I don't think they're too... That one was invisible. This don't seem to care about me at all. So I'm going to go and just check out our little base over here again. I picked up some of the plant stuff that I wanted to try. I'll pick that up. So let's see. We got 12 bottles of stuff, which is good. Energy container. This is for the small fuel tank. Guess that can go in there. I don't know. I haven't quite figured all that out yet, but I'll take those bottles. And I wanted to take growing plot, and I wanted to see if I could place that down anywhere. Does it need to be in water? Okay, so it looks like it needs to be attached up here. So why don't we do that? Why don't we go ahead and attach it like so? And if I come up, there's nothing really there. So I brought actually a few of the little sprouts over. We can plant that, and then we can plant that. Good. And then I should have grabbed a few. So we got 41 Promethean ore. I should have grabbed a few... more hull blocks. So let's do that. Let's run back over here. We will see about grabbing some more hull blocks. I can run. I can jump. I can run. I can jump. And I've been picking this alien plasma, and I'm not sure what it's for. One of the next major goals, I think, in this, and what we're doing here is going to be to make a food processor, because that actually does a lot of different stuff that I'm not entirely sure about. But we're going to take this Promethean ore. We're going to just click as many times as we can. I'm sure it's going to be 41, right? Or 40 at this point. I don't know. it's going to take a little while for all of that to craft up, but we should end up with just a ton of this ore. I mean, we got 30 of that already. That's another 3 of these. I'm going to make probably 5 of those. What are those things? You see that? I'm scared. I am literally scared for my life. Let's turn this off for a second. I want to just cut that process. Come back over here and make... 10 of you, and turn that back on. I'm a little scared. Alright, so I don't know exactly where they're going. But like I said, I'm a little nervous. It'll be okay. Alright, so we made 30 of those. It's going to take... So let's just make 10 of those. And then we should have... Yeah, we got quite a bit of... I mean, not a lot of power use, but we got some power use. Cool. And then, like I said, the thing that I want to make next is actually this, the food processor. It takes two computers. Computer. So it takes one control device. And I don't know if I have enough to make two. We'll make another control device. Two more. No, we're probably good on metal components. And then we can make another computer. So it takes two computers, two control devices. Yeah. And then a couple of pipes. We can make two of those. So we need three more electronics. And we'll need two more control devices, right? Yeah, that should be good. And then we can make that. But I'm a little nervous. With whatever that was walking around over there, we're on an alien planet. Like, I don't know what's going on, but... And I think I'm going to take what's in here and take this aloe vera and just put it away a little bit, because that is taking up a lot of our storage space. So hopefully we can sprint back over here real quick. Egg... Oh, what was that? Oh, it was one of those. Alright, so it looks like there's maybe a little bit of a dust storm going on right now. It's not bad, but it's not necessarily good. Oh, we like cleared that. Did you see that? That was kind of cool. Alright, so let's... just put up some walls back there. I hear the little buggers. Alright, and then let's take one of these plant growth lights. And actually, I want to try... Oh no, that's not what I wanted. Dang it. That is not what I wanted at all. That went in no way the way that I wanted it to go. Alright. That sucks. Oh, I walked off. Not good. Alright, so these lights are tiny, so I don't think they're quite working the way that they should. Yeah, it doesn't look like they want to participate. But these lights... they're not too bad. And they might need some sort of power. And I don't know necessarily what these will need either. And these guys just end up being huge. So, like, I feel like these are almost for, like, small ships. Which is not necessarily good. Alright, we keep running here. Gonna head back. We could pick up some more alien plasma, but I don't think I'm going to just yet. And then, hopefully we can get this processor. There we go. Food processor. Very nice. And then, let's see. What is left? I'll need a reactor core. I'll need a motor. Three pipes. Three electronics. And 10 metal components, which we have. And then in here, we'll just take one of these, put it in. And she should be set to build. And that'll give us a reactor core. And then we'll just need two control devices. just like so. Three electronics and two computers. So three electronics and two computers, which will give us that. Okay, so let's go ahead and take our food processor over there and see what we can do with it. It looks tiny, but I'm assuming that once we get it on that those bigger blocks. So I'm assuming this is kind of in the vein of Space Engineers, where you have big ships and bases and little ships and stuff like that. I'm going to try and see if I can't maybe, you know, get on a call with a guy. All right, let's see. There's nothing wrong with it. I'm just personally terrible at, like, rotation. All right, so let's see. Food processor, perfect. Let's just go ahead and just put some stuff in and see if maybe we come up with anything good. So we can actually make some grilled steak. I don't think crushed stone's going to do anything for us. Alien plasma. There's some fiber. Drill charge, portable water. Cool. All right, so we actually can make a grilled steak. There's space fries. There's salami. There's ham. Wow, there's actually a bunch of stuff that we can make. There's a nutrient solution. Some more growing plats. Let's go ahead and make that raw meat. Oh, you know what? This is probably going to take power. So let's go ahead and sprint back over here. See about picking up that generator. And I don't know if, like, this has to be connected to these blocks to be able to get power like this, or if... I don't know. I'm not really sure how it's supposed to work. But we'll find out, won't we? All right, so it's made that. It's making the second computer, which is good. Okay, so now if I need 12 metal components, and I need 2 control devices, and that should unlock the small generator for me, because I don't really have anything left. And then once that's done processing, I will make... Let's see, how many more plates do we have? We only have one. It takes 2 metal plates, so we'll just do that. And then the rest for now, I'm gonna just process the Promethean ore and get a few more of that as well. All right, come on, man. 0.4 minutes remaining. Let's go ahead and jump back out, and we'll put in there we go. As long as we remember to turn it off, that's not a problem. Right? All right. Just taking a quick look at the wiki. Yeah, nothing crazy over there. Come on. So with all that in there, how long do we have left? We have 40 minutes left. That's awesome. That is awesome. All right, come on. That should be... Once we get these 2 control devices... There we go. Oh, we can actually make it there. But I guess I'll just make another one. I guess I forget to look. Oh, that's going to take forever. All right. So we've got 4 minutes until daytime. We need health, food, oxygen. You name it, we need it. Let's come over here. Okay, we refill our oxygen. Very good. Crap. I left my food back over there. So there's that. And that's about halfway done. So, the crafting times, like, it doesn't say exactly how long it's going to take to craft it. It might be nice to see that. I don't know. But like I said, I think I'm going to try and reach out to the devs a little bit and see if I can't get some knowledge, get some stuff that maybe I'm not finding on the wiki right away. I'm curious, is there anything, like if I just dig down, like right here? Am I going to find anything worthwhile? There's nothing to pick up. But it's created this nice little hole, and like it's kind of flat. If I turn my jetpack on, I should be able to get out. And I did. But that's kind of cool. Like, this game is definitely... got a lot of potential to it, and I am really excited to play it more. All right, so let's go ahead. This thing is looking kind of small here. But if we have to place it on our stuff over here, it's probably, like I said, going to get rather large. So we've had... I don't know. Let's see. Jump up. Small generator. Access to fuel tank. What? Is that because you're not technically connected to any blocks? Is that what's going on here? Give me that. Let's see. Let's rotate this sucker around. Cannot be placed on this block base. Okay. That's terrible. All right, so maybe it needs to be connected to something like this. So maybe in the next episode what we'll do is we're going to craft up one of those, I think, removal tools and see about using that on all this stuff. But guys, that's going to be it for today. I hope you enjoyed this another episode of Imperium, and I will see you guys in the next one. I'm